A Gift of Chopples. Two lectures we have completed, and today is the third one, last one. Up to the children gave chopples of music master's chopples to beggar, and when music lecture was over, music master and Lolly were searching for chopples right in the veranda. Up to here we have done. Now next is page number 26. Rukmani caught sight of Ravi, Mridu and Meena sitting under the tree. "Have you children?" she began, and then seeing they were. Now Rukmani, when she came, right, when she heard about the chappals are missing and music master and Lalli are searching for chappal, Rukmani came there. She looked at Ravi, Mridu and Meena, and she asked that, "Have you children?" Means she want to ask that they have hided the chappal anywhere. Curiously find and went on more slowly, seen anyone lurking around the veranda. And what she saw that children, they are not paying attention. Lurking means they are not paying attention towards what Rukmani was speaking. A sharp V-shaped line had formed between her eyebrows. Sharp V-shaped lines were there. Means which shows that she was very angry. And another straight, tighter one appeared in place of her usually soft, pleasant mouth, as she always used to speak in a pleasant manner. But now this time, her voice became louder and she was very angry. Rukmani was angry, thought Mridu with shiver. Now what Mridu thought, that Rukmani is now angry, what will happen? She wouldn't be so upset if she knew about the poor beggar with sores on his feet, and she tried to tell herself. Now as Mridu come to know that Rukmani is angry, what she thought, that if Rukmani come to know about the blisters on the beggar's feet, she will not be angry. Now Mridu tried to explain herself that if Rukmani will come to know about this blisters of beggar, she will not be angry. Taking a deep breath, she cried, "Rukmani, there was a beggar here. Poor thing, he had such boils on his feet." And now Mridu, she had taken a breath and see what she said to Rukmani, that here one beggar was there and he had boils on his feet. Means Mridu told to Rukmani that here one beggar was there and he had boils on his feet. "So," said Rukmani grimly, turning to Ravi, "you gave the music master's chappals to that beggar, old beggar, you turns up here." And now as Mridu told that here one beggar was there and he had boils on his leg, so Rukmani turned towards Ravi, and what she told to Ravi, that means you have to give a music master's chappals to beggar. "Children these days," groaned Pati. And now Pati become angry. She say, "Children these days," mean she wants to tell that children of these days are not listening to anyone and they do what they want to do. "Amma, didn't you tell me about Karne who gave away everything he had, even his gold earrings? He was so kind and generous." Now Ravi was arguing with his mother that, "Mamma, you told me about Karan," means his mother has told him story of Karan, that Karan was very kind, he was donating everything, even he donated his gold earrings to someone. So Ravi was arguing with his mother that you told me about Karan, right, and he was very kind and he was donating everything. "Silly," snapped Rukmani. "Karan didn't give away other people's things. He only gave away his own." So what Rukmani told to Ravi, that Karan was not giving anyone's things. He was giving donating his own things, right? He was not giving some other's things to anyone, right? "But my chappals wouldn't have fitted the beggar's feet." Ravi rushed brashly on Amma. "If they did fit, would you really not have minded?" Now what Ravi said, that my slippers wouldn't fit that beggar, right? So I have given music master's slippers to beggar, and if my slippers were fitted to him, definitely I had given him, and I think you don't mind about it. Ravi said Rukmani, very angry now. Go inside this minute. And now Rukmani was very angry. She told Ravi to get into the house. She hurried indoors and brought out Gopu Mama's hardly worn new chappals. This should fit you. Sir, please put this on. I am so sorry. My son has been naughty. The music master's eyes light up. He put them on, trying not to be looked too happy. Now, Rukmani, she hurried in the house and brought Gopu Mama's hardly worn chappals, right? And she had given to music master and told, sorry that my son has done much mischief, right? And the music master's eyes light up. Unki aankh, music master ki aankh mein chamak aa gayi, because his chappals were old and this one are new. But he put on them. He put on that chappals, but he was showing that he was not happy. Well, I suppose this will have to do. These days, children have no respect for elders. What to do? A Hanuman incarnate, only Ram can save such a naughty fellow. And as music master put on the chappals, he was trying to hide his happiness. Actually, he was very happy because he got new one, and he was trying to hide his happiness. And what he said, there's children of these days, and they don't have respect for elders. And he compared Ravi with Hanuman, means compared like a monkey, right? Rukmani's eyes flashed. She didn't seem to like Ravi being called a monkey. Now Rukmani, she didn't like that music master has told Ravi as a monkey. She stood stiff and straight by the front door. It was clear she wanted him to leave quickly. And she stood near the front door. That shows that she wanted that music master to leave quickly. When he had clattered off in his new chappals, he said, Pritu, come in and have some tiffin. And as music master gone away with new chappal, what Rukmani said to Pritu, that come in and have some tiffin, means let's have, eat something. Honestly, how do you children think of such things? Thank God, your Gopu Mama doesn't wear his chappals to work. And honestly, what she asked, that how this thought came to your mouth, in your mind, that to give Gopu Mama's chappal to the beggar. And thank God that he was not wearing that chappal to the work. As she walked towards the kitchen with Mridu and Meena, she suddenly began to laugh. And as she went into the kitchen with Mridu and Meena, she suddenly started laughing. But he is always in such a hurry to throw off his shoes and socks and get into his chappals, and as soon as he comes home. And now Rukmani, she started laughing because she was knowing that whenever Gopu Mama come into the house, he thrown off his shoes and socks. And what's your mama going to say this evening when I tell him I gave his chappal to the music master? And what she said, that when in the evening, when Gopu Mama will come and he will not see his chappals, then what will happen? When I will tell him everything that about chappals I have given to music master. Thank you. Now let's do the recall of chapter A Gift of Chappals. This chapter is of one girl, Mridu. She was living with her grandparents. One day they went to meet her cousins, Ravi, Meena and Lali, right? And they entered into the house, Ravi dragged Mridu into at the backyard. There they hide one kitten, right? And which they got from the near the gate in the morning. And they hide this secret from their parents, right? And now Ravi wanted some milk for kitten. So he acted like that he is hungry and he asked milk. Right, he asked for milk, but his Pati, she was in doubt that Ravi is hiding something. So she asked to drink the milk and give me tumbler back in that way. So Ravi acted like that he is drinking milk, and he told his Pati that I will wash the tumbler. And as early as Pati went away, Ravi ran at the backyard and he poured the milk in the coconut shell. And Ravi compared this kitten with the Rishi cat of Mahabalipuram. Like he told that this cat is descendant of the Rishi cat of Mahabalipuram, right? And as they were talking about cat, he has given him a name, M.P. Punnai, right? As they were talking about this cat, some screeching voice was coming from the window, screech, screech, screech. So now Mridu was looking at there, who is making such noise, and even that kitten, M.P. Punnai, was also frightened of this noise. So he tried to hide himself in under the rat chilies, right? In some tray, rat chilies were kept there. So he tried to hide himself under the chilies. And then Mridu and Ravi and Meena went near the window. There they saw Lalli was playing violin, and her music master was sitting in front of Lalli near the window. Right? He was a music master, was a bony figure and bare-headed person. Right? And he was wearing a gold chain and a diamond ring. The music played by music master was very good and proper. It was compared right like the train is running on the track. He was playing violin without stop. Right? She was going on playing, going on, going on. And suddenly what happened? Some noise of beggar came. Amma, Amma, give me. And as they went near the garden, they saw one beggar was sitting under the tree, and he has taken out his upper cloth and spread it on the ground, and he was supposed to take a snooze. So Ravi's mother Rukmani, she shouted that Ravi, tell him to go away from here and tell him not to come again. Ravi was not supposed to repeat the words of his mother because Rukmani shouted like anything. So the beggar told that just take me rest under the tree. I will go back from here because the road is too hot and I have blisters on my leg. So I will move on. And the ladies of these houses are very kind and generous. They allow me to survive from last week, 1 week. And I will go after the, I will take rest. As Mridu, Ravi and Meena saw the blisters on the beggar, they were surprised. And they thought that this, Mridu thought that this person, the beggar, he didn't have money to buy the pair of chappals. So Mridu asked Ravi that don't you think that we should do anything for him, and it's very unfair if we will not give him a pair of chappals. So Ravi said that only a pair of chappal is needed, let's do something. So they went into the house and there they found a pair of chappals of music master, which was very large in size and old. So Ravi had taken that pair of chappals and he had given to beggar. Now what happened, as the music lecture of music was over, music master came out of the room and he started to search his chappals. But he didn't get it, right? He didn't get his chappals because children had given his chappals to the beggar. Now he started shouting like anything, Lalli, Lalli, where is my chappals? Have you seen? And Lalli started searching it, but she didn't get the chappals. And then Lalli tried to inform her mother. And music master was continuously speaking that it was a brand new chappal and I have brought it from the Mount Road and the cost of the chappal is 1 month's fees. Like in this way he was shouting. So Rukmani came out and Pati also came after her. Rukmani asked her children, Ravi, Meena and Mridu, they are sitting under the tree. She asked, have you? But they didn't answer, and they were showing that they are not interested in all this matter. I was in fear that if Rukmani will come to know that we have given chappal to beggar, she will be angry. Right? So Mridu told her that that one beggar had blisters on his legs. Now Rukmani turned towards Ravi and she told that how you can give the chappal to that beggar. So Ravi argued with his mother that you told me story of girl who always gave his things to many people. Right? Even Karan had given his gold earrings. So Rukmani told that Karan was giving his things, not others' things. Now suddenly Rukmani went into the house and she brought a pair of chappals and she gave to music master and she said, sorry that my children has become naughty and I'm very sorry for you. And that music master was become happy because it was a new pair of chappal, right? But he showed that he was unhappy with this and he put on his chappals and went out. Now Rukmani and Mridu and Meena went into the kitchen and Rukmani started laughing because she told that how when this Gopu mama come back from his office and he will search his chappal, at that time I will explain him that his chappal is given to the music master. Thank you.
आभार।